I hope you are able to hear me and you are able to watch my screen. Okay. So yesterday session we talked about enterprise structure. So how we are going to perform the enterprise structure, that's what we discussed yesterday. So the first setup what we'll be doing in the real time is enterprise structure configurator. Last session we talked about enterprise structure configurator. First we'll be defining an enterprise. Enterprise is nothing but name of the company. Within that we'll go for divisions. Division is nothing but a group of business which we are going to perform. It may be for one person or for multiple persons we are doing it. And then divisions are optional. In fact, it's not mandatory. Okay. And then we will see the legal entities where the entities are defined legally registered. And business units are nothing but a branches. And reference data set is nothing but a set of information which we are assigning to the BU. What information we'll see in the reference data set? We'll see departments, jobs, locations, and grades. This all information we'll see that here it is. Okay. And then we are going to ask the clients whenever we are defining any department, is the department or job or any of these four business objects. Okay. So if client says that object I want for all the business units, we have to define that object under common reference data set. Under common reference data set. If we make it as an only for a particular business units, we have to make that as for custom reference data set. We have to make it as custom reference data set, this option. Now go to setup and maintenance. Manage implementation projects. Yesterday we defined implementation project as Metro and enter the task name, establish enterprise structures. These task names we have to remember. In the initial stage, it looks like a little bit complex, but once we start practicing the application, it will be very easy. It's not that much complex. In fact, in the interview point of view, also, they'll ask you what is the name of the task. Not each and every task. Important tasks like this. Important tasks like this. When I search for an established enterprise structure task, it is showing two times. Why it is showing two times? As yesterday we talked about, the global HR module. Global HR module is common for both workforce deployment and workforce development. So it means all the global HR tasks will be available. All the global HR tasks will be available in both the offerings. It will be available in both the offerings. So that's the reason it is going to show that two times. If we choose any task name, not a problem. Whether we choose this one, okay. Or if we choose this one also, it's okay. So let me go for this. Establish enterprise structures. In case if at all we want to know the navigation exactly in which offering, in which feature, in which task list this particular task is exist, there is an option here, show hierarchy. If we click, it will shows exactly where this particular task name is exist. Open the task list here. We can see a lot of enterprises are there, enterprise structures. But right now, if we look at here right side, no enterprise is loaded successfully into the database. No enterprise is loaded successfully into the database. Here it is. Okay, so now I am creating new enterprise structure. New enterprise, I'm going to say Metro. Name of the enterprise, this. This we are going to define. After defining the enterprise, we'll ask the client about the divisions. So client says that I have a business in India and US, and I would like to treat India as a separate business and US is a separate business, separate division. We can make it as like this, or we can make it as a separate divisions like the area of the business or domain of the business. For example, finance and manufacturing. They would like to treat financials as a separate division and manufacturing a separate division. Like that, we can do it. So right now, if we look at here, establish enterprise structures is the task name where we are going to define an enterprise. We have to enter the enterprise information, nothing but name of the company. I have entered enterprise name called Metro, but here some other name is populating. I'm not able to see the Metro. Some other name is populated. I'll tell you that later. Why we are getting, I'll tell you that later. Okay. So now enter this option here. And primary industry of your enterprise. What is the basic industry of your enterprise here? What is the primary industry of your enterprise? Let's say your client is construction business. We'll choose construction business. Here it is. Okay, then headquarters. I'm going to say that headquartered is in India. Headquarter is in India here. And legal information. Legally, where exactly this particular enterprise is registered. That's a legal information we are going to specify. These all details must be provided by the client because we do not have the idea. Legal entity number and registration number. Reporting registration. Legal address. Legally, where exactly it is. If address is already created, then we are going to select. If not, we'll create here. In case if we want to modify the address location, we can do it. So let me create an address here. It is. And Metro Delhi office address Delhi pin code. And state is Delhi here. Press OK. Thank you. Okay, so we entered an enterprise information. Obviously, when we registered an enterprise, that is a legal. It's an ultimate holding company headquarters. Okay, so legal information also we have to enter. One legal entity also created. Okay, now here Oracle is telling us, you have provided enough information to configure simple enterprise with one legal entity and one country. One legal entity and one country. Okay. So are you okay with this? Because some clients will have only one enterprise, one country, then fine. If the client is having multiple legal entities, multiple countries, or single country with multiple legal entities, what we have to do is we have to select, continue with the interview to set up more legal entities, or we can complete the setup here itself. Or we can complete the setup here itself. Okay, so now once we define an enterprise, once we define an enterprise here, okay, then we are going for divisions. Click next button. If it is only one, that we can call it as headquarter as a division, Sravya. But division is completely different definition. Division means, for example, your client is having Maruti, as I told yesterday, Maruti has got different divisions. That's a group of business. But divisions has got, it doesn't have much, it doesn't have any much impact in Fusion applications. It doesn't have any much impact in the divisions. It is optional, in fact. Okay. We can say that group of similar business process. So now in this example, I'm going to take this example. I'm going to take here it is. I'm going to take it as two divisions. One is for India, another one is for US. Metro India. Select this and go for create Metro US. I'm creating US location. There is something called geography concept. So that time we'll discuss. That time we'll discuss how to go for locations data loading by using the geography tags and all. No, Bhupal. Yes, exactly, Shyam. Enterprise is nothing but a business group. Bhupal, division we cannot treat as a branch. Division is nothing but a similarity of the business. Okay, so let's say I'm doing automobile business and telecom business and retail industry. So three divisions like that. Branch is nothing but a business units. Business, this is very high level, top level options. Okay, like we can say South India division, North India division, we can call like that. So now in this example, we are going to have two divisions. Obviously, we have to ask the client how many divisions they are expecting, or we can go ahead with having the options of divisions. So we can also suggest to the client different types of divisions. Here it is. Okay, so once we define a divisions, then it's going to ask me after enterprise and division, next is a legal entity, right? So click next button. Okay. So whenever we go to legal entities task here, whenever we go to legal entity task, by default one legal entity is there. But this is ultimate holding company. This is ultimate holding company. So by default, this legal entity is available here. It is. By default, it is available here. It is. Okay. So because at the time of creating an enterprise itself, we entered enterprise information and also the legal information. Both we have entered, right? So that time itself, ultimate holding company, that's a legal entity, has been created here. It is. Now I am going to create new legal entities. If you want to create automatically the legal entities, that can be also created. So if you want manual creation, we can do, or we can go for create automatically also. Now I'm going to say that in India, how many legal entities we would like to have at this point of time? 3. India, Metro Hyderabad Division, Metro India. Legal address. Create. Hyderabad. I'm just going ahead with 2 legal entities in India. One is Hyderabad, another one is Bangalore. Go for second one. We would like to have one legal entity in US. Let me create another legal entity. This is for US division, United States. Metro Chicago. Metro US. This is all legal information we'll get from the client, and we'll go for select the options. So create for US location here. this. Like this we can create. For example, today we are implementing Fusion to the client. After 6 months or 1 year, the client would like to go for have one more legal entity. Then we can go for add. It's not a problem. This is in the initial setup. We are going to implement. After some time, if client want to add that, then we can go for attach. Here it is. Now after legal entities, we'll ask the client in every legal entity, what are the business units are there? What are the business units are there? Here it is. Okay, so now we'll go for create business units. Create business units here. Yes. Ravi, the ultimate legal entity is nothing but a headquarters, company headquarters, that is by default. So company may not be, legal entity is basically legally registered office where the company income tax returns and files, tax related documents will be prepared and submitted to the government of a particular country. Okay. So you can have either one legal entity or multiple. So that is the ultimate holding company where you are going to consolidate the remaining all legal entity accounting information. Next, we are going for business units. So after legal entities, what is the next task is the business unit here, if you look at. We are going for business units. Here it is. So the business units we are going to perform according to the client requirement here. So we can have automatically we can generate the business unit, or depends on the requirement. Manually also we can create a business units. Manually also we can create the business units. So I'm going to select manual option, manually create business units, or we can say that automatic first based now when you select automatically for every country you want to have one BU, or based on the legal entity you would like to have a BU. It's up to the requirement we are going to create based on legal entity, and I'm going to select all BU we would like to create. All business units we would like to go for create. Here it is. And manage business unit means you can create, you can add additional, you can go for add the additional business units. You can go for add additional business units. Here it is. Okay. Now we can see business unit code and business unit name. BU stands for business unit. Yeah. Business unit. And the business units are associated with Hyderabad. So let's say this is SR Nagar business unit. And it is active status, India, and Hyderabad this is. Okay, so now how we would like to have the additional BU. For example, if you look at in Hyderabad, there are 4 business units. Right now, one I have created, right? SR Nagar. So that is already assigned. That is already assigned to this, right? Okay, then how can I create a ESI business unit? Yes. So what you have to do is you have to go for here manually and mention that ESI is the code. ESI business unit, active, country, India, and location, Hyderabad and save. But here if we look at, this BU is not associated with any legal entity. Just BU, business unit, is created. But it is not associated with any legal entity. That we have to attach manually. Here we cannot perform. If at all any new business units we are creating, that should be added manually. Here it is. Okay, so that's about manage business units and create business units here. Yes, we know that is visible only, right? That will be available at the time of, in legal entity, not here. That is an ultimate holding company is just for consolidation purpose. Okay. So that is, we are not going to perform any transactions in the ultimate holding legal company. That is just for, you might have seen something called consolidate some business accounting transaction, corporations, income limited, like that. Okay, now click next button. So now business units are completed. We created a business units here. So we created business units. I've shown you how to assign to the legal entity here, right? Next. After creating the business unit, what is the next one? Reference data set. Next is a reference data set. So one reference data set is nothing but a group of departments. Group of departments, jobs, grades, and locations. Jobs, grades, and locations. We are going to see here it is, right? That. So here, as I told the last session, one default reference data set we'll see, that is common. Common reference data set, by default it is visible. By default, it is available for all the business unit. Depends on our requirement, we will create the new one. Depends on our requirement, we will go for create new one. Okay, so enterprise set generally we don't use because we will have only one enterprise for one instance. We don't find multiple enterprises here, right? Okay, so then here. So then these all are depends on the requirement. We will see that here. It is. We can also create our own reference data set. Here it is. So this is manage reference data set, creating the reference data sets. I'm not clear, Sham. Code means code in the sense. We don't find any code. Just reference data set is nothing but simply group of departments we have to create. So common reference data set is there. For example, you are creating one department name called IT. Then it will ask, system will ask you, this IT department comes under which reference data set? Is it common or other? If it is common, that reference date, that department is global, applicable for all the business units. If it is other reference data set, only for a selected business unit, whatever we are going to assign. Okay, so that anyway we'll be seeing practically whenever we are creating reference data set and assigning the departments and business unit. Right now we are using the enterprise structure configurator tool and we are going to perform all this. Later we will be doing all this manually also. Okay. Next, manage business unit set assignment. So we are going to how to assign the reference data set to the business unit. Just now we created how to create the reference data set, then assign reference data set to business unit. This is all already we are performing, right? Here it is. So we can choose the reference data set. Here it is. So here manage business unit set assignment. We are going to assign reference data set to the business unit. Now click next button. Now we can also assign our reference data set to the location, but generally we don't use this. It is for future purpose. Oracle has configured, not right now. Right now reference data sets and business units. We are not going to have any other things here. And click next button. Now we can see the interview result here. And this is all process, we call it as an interview result. And it is telling us that your enterprise name is this. These are the divisions you have. Two divisions, this many legal entities you have. And these are the business units we have. And these are the reference data sets. Same information I can see graphically also here. We can check this graphically also. Here it is. We can show that information. Okay, and click save and close. Yeah, that we are going to see Venu practically later. Practically next level we'll see the definitely result. Yes, Sayid, the department is like in EBS. Yes, cost center. Yeah, department concept is not there in EBS. Department. Yes, that concept is not there. Cost center we have, right? That will be yes. Exactly. So now where we have defined this, an enterprise structure is this metro. This is what our enterprise structure. this, and we can see the result here, and it is right now it is not loaded. If you go for load, it will show the error message. It will shows the error message. Because why it will show the error message? Whatever the enterprise structure you have defined, you cannot load. Okay, you cannot load here. It is. Because only one enterprise structure is allowed in one instance. We cannot go for multiple. We cannot go for multiple options. Here it is. Okay, so that's, so in this example, in this instance, the enterprise is already loaded. The enterprise is already loaded. So whatever we have defined, it is a draft. Whatever we have defined, it is draft. It cannot be uploaded. It cannot be used here. It is. How to find which enterprise is loaded? Go to the task, manage enterprise, HCM information. Go to the task, manage enterprise, HCM information. Yeah, we must be the first person. If at all we want to see our structure, for example, Metro we have created, right? If we want to load the Metro, definitely we should be the first person. But as we are in the training environment, already some people might have created the enterprise and they might have already uploaded. So this is the name of the enterprise. Of course, we can modify this. Okay. Only enterprises cannot be created. Remaining enterprise cannot be created. Remaining all things we will create. Our own divisions, our own legal entities, everything we are going to do next level here. We'll create our own divisions, legal entities, business units, departments, and all we are going to perform here. It is. Okay. So here, this is an enterprise, which actually in fresh environment, when we are working in the real time, obviously client will buy the licensed version. That is going to be the fresh environment. So in that scenario, we will see that. So how to load is simple. We have to just click the button. We have to just click the button, then it will be loaded. Okay, fine. So this is how we can go for configure enterprise structure, how we can do it by using enterprise structure configurator tool. ESE is one of the tool like wizard based. By using this tool, we are going to configure an enterprise structure. Okay. After that, we will go for define manually also. But it is mandatory, it's one-time configuration. Once we configure enterprise structure and load, again, I cannot go back to this place. Again, I cannot go back to enterprise structure tool. I cannot go back to establish enterprise structure. It's one-time setup. So here in our training, we are seeing a lot of other options. But when we are working in the real time, we'll create an enterprise structure like this. After creating this, we will go for load it. That's it. Next time we cannot load again. And in case if you want to make some changes, you have to perform manually. Manually, we have to go for perform the operations here. So that's the first option, enterprise structure. So next session will be on Monday. This is our demo session. Third one is completed. And Monday, the meeting ID will be changed. Please contact Mr. Naresh and get the new meeting ID. So Monday we'll go ahead with other. Okay, fine. Let me know any doubts you have so that I can clarify the things now regarding the course, time and other things. Any doubts here? Yeah, Ravi, in Gulf countries, just now it is started here. It is in Qatar and all, because they are the main HRMS, EBS, they are using. Yes. So book coexistence is nothing but integrations with all this. Integrations with all these options. Okay, thank you. Let's see you guys on Monday. Contact Naresh for that new meeting ID. Thank you.